Exit right, 54, towards New London.
Okay, we're off to another air conditioner pickup. This is the first one.
Take the exit right.
And probably one of few. Because we're going to try not to go crazy with the conditioners again this year. This is a Westinghouse model. Probably a 5000. And I believe it's going to be a late 70s at the White Westinghouse.
After 1.2 miles, take the exit right, Interstate 95 northbound, towards New London.
It's kind of late at night here. It's about 8 o'clock. But this is only 20 minutes away, so it's not a big deal. The guy called me and says, come now. It's okay. So, I don't know if the camera angle is any good. I had kind of figured out some way that the clamp would sit on the dash properly, but I couldn't figure it out again. I didn't have time to play with it, so I just set it up however it is now. But it is what it is. It might be too high, but you should be able to at least see the street lights, which I think will have some sodium ones on this road. Although it looks like we're getting off real quick, so maybe not. We might not see it.
After 1/2 mile, take the exit right, Interstate 95 northbound, towards New London. Then, keep left.
We've got a few beautiful sodium lights here. The illumination is so much better.
Take the exit right, then, keep left. Exit right, 36th, towards Plains Road, then sharp left.
So this is kind of interesting. It looks like some of these are DEL and some are sodium. Hopefully
take the exit right, then sharp left.
Hopefully they're only getting replaced as they fail. I mean, even that's a shame. But I think I missed a turn because I was distracted by the street lights. Yeah, I definitely...
Left turn ahead.
Oh.
Plains Road.
That was a waste of a few minutes. Oh well.
Sharp left, then turn left, Interstate 95 northbound, towards New Haven.
These are all sodium here. Sadly, this is becoming such a rare sight. There's hardly any sodium left anywhere around here. Jeez, this is taking forever. At least we should be getting a good picture of this street light here.
Follow. Interstate 95 northbound towards Hartford for 10 miles.
Okay.
towards Hartford, then stay in the right lane. Keep left, then stay in the right lane.
Normally I don't make sudden movements like that, but there was nobody in sight. It's always better to just miss the turn and then go back and fix it.
Turn right, Forbes Place, then turn left, Kimberley Avenue. Turn left.
That's kind of weird.
At the end of the road, turn left, Highway 100, High Street. Turn left. Then, turn right.
Mistakes on the way home, and maybe we'll see some more sodium
turn
lights
left,
again.
Highway 80, Foxen Road.
There's that reciprocating compressor sound. That trafficway is busted. It's probably DEL.
After 1/2 mile, turn right, Interstate 91 southbound, towards New Haven. Then, take the freeway.
Oh, come on, what is this? This moron is halfway into the road. Get off the phone and pay attention. It's so important to pay attention. People's lives are at stake if you don't pay attention. Ugh.
towards Merritt Parkway.
Unfortunately, the camera overheated on the way home. I forgot that some of the heat in the car leaks out on the like the defrost register when I have it onto the floor. And so unfortunately the heat was pouring onto the camera and it overheated, which is a shame because there was a lot of really nice sodium streetlights I wanted to get on video. But regardless, here's the machine. It's in immaculate condition. Not a scratch on it. Where's the data sheet? It says 6,000 BTU. And it's 22, of course. 19.5 ounces. I can't quite see what the date is, but 7.5 amps. I think this is a one or two season unit. Very little use on it. It's kind of a weird looking compressor. It doesn't sound very nice. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. Sounds a little harsher than usual. At least compared to what we usually sound like. Very, very clean inside. Coil is clear all the way to the bottom. Very little rust. Coming out cold with 100 something degree air going right in. And look at this. The side panels are intact and in good condition. These are almost impossible to find in good shape because of course the sun just breaks this down. So that is super rare. I think what I would do is I would put a piece of wood on the outside just to keep the sun off of these. Because these are perfect on both sides. The material is still strong. It's not even deteriorated. It's amazing to find these in this bit of shape. Alright, so we'll have a better video taking this apart, cleaning it up, etc. later on. But just wanted to get a quick test, make sure it works, and it absolutely does.